well, maybe like the Quran, it's not all of it is God's word. Like maybe like the Prophet, he put some like words in it. I don't know.
The one who created the universe, the one who created the whole world, is making a verse, says, hey female, any one of you would like to have a bang bang bing bong with the Prophet, give yourself to the Prophet. Come on, show me, silence me, teach me. I mean, come on.
Well, like this is well, maybe like the Quran, it's not all of it is God's word. Like maybe like the Prophet, he put some like words in it. I don't know.
What do you mean? What does this have to do with God? You see, I am a Christian prayer. Let us say I am claiming that I am a prophet, and then I come here in this chat. I have like 1,000 people listening, and I say to them, "Hey, females in the, you know, who wanna sleep with me? Come on, this is crazy. This is sick. This can't be from God. Muhammad already had many wives. He had many slave girls sleeping with them. Why he need a verse from God to say any woman she want to give herself to the Prophet? Obviously Muhammad now taking advantage of the people, he became a prophet, he became powerful, and he want to have sex with everybody. He don't even respect his followers. Otherwise you tell me, what is the benefit of this? What does this have to do with God? Why God, he was putting his nose in the panty of Muhammad and the panties of the believers? This is about panties, about those sex. And Muhammad is not a single guy, so Allah, he's trying to find him a good wife. He had many wives already. So what this is about? It's very obvious that Muhammad is fabricating a verse trying to get women into his bed, claiming that God told him. He's not the guy who cared for that, man. I'm busy. And look what happened. When ugly women, they start coming to Muhammad, what Muhammad he did? Muhammad, he said to himself, uh-oh, I'm getting many ugly women now after I made this verse. So what I will do? I am going to make another verse says, I have the right to choose the one I like, and I will refuse the one I don't like. I mean, have you ever heard of madness like this? Look what he said. You, O Muhammad, S-A-W, can postpone the women who you will. Postpone? What does that mean? Women, they start coming to Muhammad, they are ugly, and he don't like how they look like. So Muhammad, he starts saying, uh-oh, I said whoever a Muslim woman, she can give herself to me, and now I have a lot of them, and many of them, they are ugly. So how I can get rid of them? So he created another verse, saying, Allah, he told me, I can postpone upon any one of you, and I choose the one I like. I mean, isn't this obvious? I mean, what kind of a prophet this prophet is?
Wait, so this verse is saying that he can postpone the turn of whom you will? What does that mean?
The women who is coming to have sex with him. You see, the Muslim in the translation, they lie, they say wives. There's none of them became a wife. Not even one of them became a wife. Those women, they want to sleep with him because he just told them in the previous verse, any one of them, they want to sleep with you, they are welcome.
You mean marry them, right?
Not what marry them? Okay, name for me one of the women who gave herself to Muhammad became a wife. Go ahead. He did not marry any of them. Never. It's just for sex. Sexy club. The Prophet sexy club.
Can you show me like the whole verse, just zoom out so I can read?
I'm showing you the whole verse. Okay, here we go. You can read it, my friend. You can open your Quran from your side if you want. And then here it says, and any believing women, you know, we can change the translation if you want. I mean, this is my translation here.
This is verse 51 of which chapter?
Verse number 50 and 51 in chapter 33. Any woman want to give herself to the Prophet, give herself to the Prophet. And come on. Women? I mean, we arrive to the point we have no shame to say that any woman she want to give herself to the Prophet? Why is that? What does this have to do with God? How I can serve God by saying any woman she can sleep with me? Unless you're Muslim, you believe that when Muhammad have sex, he have orgasm, and Allah, he have orgasm by Muhammad. Otherwise, what joy that will bring to Allah?
I don't know. This is
disgusting, isn't it? You have to agree, my friend. Come on. I advise you to leave Islam immediately.
Well, I don't know, because like, well,
come on, be honest with yourself. You see, you are a gentleman. You are a gentleman. And I'm sure you don't accept such a thing. I don't think your family, I don't think your history, I don't think your mother, your father are bad people. I think you are coming from a good family. So how in the world you accept such a man come to you and says, any woman she can give herself to me? What does this have to do with God? What servant I'm doing to God by sleeping with Muhammad? Be honest with yourself, my friend. You see, I'm not against you. When I talk to Muslims, they think I hate them. I don't hate Muslims. I would never hate them. My Lord, he ordered me to love everybody. So I am here trying to help you, to show you that what you believe in is a scam. This man is not speaking for God. He's speaking for his panty. He's speaking for his private part. What the point of this? You see, giving charity, I understand why giving charity is very good. Helping others is very good. But, and you know, all good things to do for others are very good. But to do it for Muhammad, it's about sex. And you will see here, it says it's a privilege only for Muhammad.